evening, and welcome to the Union County Board of Chosen Freeholders Thursday, March 7th, 2019 agenda-setting meeting, and I call this meeting to order, and Clerk of the Board, would you please call the roll?
Present.
Freeholder Estrada just said he's present, but he stepped out for a moment. Freeholder Garrettson?
Here.
Freeholder Granados?
Here.
Freeholder Hudak?
Here.
Freeholder Palmieri Mudet?
Here.
Freeholder Staton?
Here.
Freeholder Williams?
Here.
Vice Chairman Mirabella?
Present.
And Chair Kowalski?
Here.
Chair, you have 9 freeholders present with 8 currently present sitting, and you have 9 freeholders present.
Thank you. And now would you please lead us in the prayer and salute to the flag.
Humbly we ask God, the giver of peace and the lover of charity, to give the entire family of nations true agreement with his will and to grant the light of his spirit on all who work for justice and peace. Amen.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Clerk, would you please read the Statement of Compliance with the Open Public Meetings Act?
The Chair wishes to announce that pursuant to the requirements of New Jersey Statutes Annotated Title 10, Chapter 4, Section 10 of the Open Public Meetings Act, adequate notice of this meeting of the Board of Chosen Freeholders of the County of Union has been given by mailing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019, along with periodic changes necessitated by circumstances, to the newspapers circulating within the County of Union who are designated to receive such notice, and by posting the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019 in the administration building, and further by filing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019 with the office of the county clerk.
Thank you. And now I'd like to call freeholders Hudak and Staton for tonight's first presentation. Would you please join me in the front? And I'd like to also call our superintendent, Ryan, of the Votech Schools. Please come forward. Thanks so much. And we're very pleased to have a number of students and their parents joining us tonight. Whenever we can talk about our vocational technical schools, it makes all of the freeholders very proud. And I'm going to hand the microphone over to our superintendent to explain what we're doing tonight.
Thank you, and if I might, I'd like to ask the students who are here with us tonight to come and join us up here. And I'm going to introduce you all and stand in front here. And while they're coming up here, good evening. As you know, February was Career and Technical Education Month. We spent the month celebrating at the Union County Vocational Technical Schools. Through activities such as guest speakers, special announcements about influential people in industry. We integrated career focus through subject areas, field trips and site visits, and evening presentations for students and their families, just to name a few examples. As a token of our appreciation for your support, you have in front of you a few items, a personalized coaster, designed and printed in the makerspace, part of our engineering program at the Magnet High School. There are also pins from HOSA, which is our Allied Health Occupations Student Association, which is housed at the Academy for Allied Health Sciences, and a pin from the FBLA, which is the Future Business Leaders of America, housed at the Academy for Information Technology. We thought that these are pins that you could wear proudly when our students compete and win, of course, at the state and national competitions coming up this spring. Finally, there are tickets for each of you for the Academy for Performing Arts production of The Addams Family to take place next Thursday, Friday, and Saturday at the Union County Performing Arts Center in Rahway. So we hope that you can join us. On behalf of the UCBTS community, we'd like to take a moment to thank the Union County Board of Chosen Freeholders for your continued support of the schools at UCBTS on our campus and for all of our programs. Tonight we have with us a group of students who we would like to introduce to you and who are we are very proud to recognize this evening for their contributions to their career and technical student organizations. And those are organizations such as HOSA, FBLA, TSA, which is the Technology Student Association, and Skills USA. So first is Kaylee Morales. She's waving. She's a 12th grade Academy for Allied Health Sciences student from Elizabeth. She's been involved in HOSA for 4 years. She is an international gold medal recipient in the Creative Problem Solving Competition. She's Vice President of Student Government at the and the Allied Health Yearbook Editor. She will be attending Tufts University next year. Right. Katrina Huang, there she is a grade 10 student, at also an Academy for Allied Health student from Cranford. She's been involved in HOSA for 2 years. Katrina is the ARC committee chair. She's received second place in behavioral health at HOSA regionals and qualified for the state competition coming up on March 16th. So you can wear that pin on behalf of Katrina. So Katrina also competed at an international competition for piano at Carnegie Hall and is a cross-country runner. All right. So next we have Justin Armendrall. He's in the middle with the blue suit jacket. He's a 12th grade student at the Magnet High School from Linden. Justin is participating with a team of six to create a unique video game. The criteria for the video game is that he be a role-playing game that is part of the Technology Student Association. Students may use any coding language they choose. He plans to major in either mechanical or aerospace engineering when he attends college next year. Lucas Bedenker is an 11th grade Academy for Information Technology student from Cranford. Lucas has been an active member of FBLA since his freshman year and will be representing UCBTS at the FBLA State Leadership Conference later this month. In his time at AIT, Lucas has earned 3 highly valued IT certifications and is the vice president of the class of 2020. Most recently, Lucas was identified by the College Board as a candidate for the National Hispanic Recognition Program. All right. Carla Tapia is an 11th grade student currently enrolled in UC Tech's Academy for Law and Justice and is from Hillside. Carla is a member of UC Tech's National Honor Society and has made honor roll or high honor roll for each marking period since her freshman year at UC Tech. She is an avid participant in the district's Future Business Leaders of America Club and will be competing in the state competition this year. She is hoping to pursue a career path in business law. Noah Sikulski is from Fanwood and is a senior at the Academy for Performing Arts. Noah has been in the theater performances at APA each year. This year he's playing the role of Lurch in our spring musical, so if you come out next week, you'll be able to see him. In 2017, he was a finalist in Montclair State University's Foxy Award for Outstanding Achievement in Special Effects New Media for his work on the APA fall play Hamlet. In 2018, he filmed and edited the promotional video for the third annual fundraiser Rockin' for Autism Music Festival at LeGrand Park in Fanwood, New Jersey. Thank you for the note. All right. Ashley Alvarenga is a UC Tech junior at the Teacher Education Academy is from Plainfield. Ashley has been a member of Educators Rising for 3 years and has held 2 officer positions, both the grade representative and president. Ashley is also a participant of Skills USA and will compete in the Occupational Health and Safety Notebook Contest on April 13th next month. Ashley plans to educate others about health and nutrition as well as pursuing a private practice and hopes to educate a community rather than in a classroom. Adriana Yataco is a 10th grade student from Roselle who attends our Cosmetology Shared Time program. She will be competing on April 13th at the New Jersey State Skills USA competition in Somerset and the Job Skills Demonstration Contest. Adriana is fluent in American Sign Language. She would like to be a lawyer for the deaf or become an interpreter in the future. She also enjoys dancing and has been a dancer for 10 years. Harshita Garg is an AIT junior from Westfield. She's been an active member of the coding club since her freshman year. Most recently, Harshita partnered with a friend to lead a series of workshops on web design. Harshita is an AP Capstone Diploma candidate, a member of FBLA, and a member of the district's robotics team. Harshita volunteers her time each week at Hindi USA, a program which teaches Hindi to young students. She has represented AIT at Kane University's NJ Chamber of Commerce Department of Education Career Awareness Day. And finally, Agent A. Wineglass from Hillside is a senior at the Academy for Performing Arts, so she's currently completing her senior year at Kane University, and she's an active member of the National Honor Society for Dance Arts. Her dance training has given her enormous opportunities to perform while also mentoring young dancers. Agent A teaches children 3 to 14 years old at the Made Stars Performing Arts School. She is also the captain of their hip-hop crew. She has performed and competed in various competitions, including the amateur night at the Apollo, where her crew made it to the final round. Busy as she is, Agent A is also the captain of her Hillside cheerleading team, where she became an All-American cheerleader. Finally, I would just take a minute to thank, if we could have our administrative team, most of them are standing already, but those who aren't, if you could just stand. I have all of our administrative staff, almost all of our administrative staff. Mrs. Douglas Jackson is at transition to Kane meeting tonight, so she wasn't able to be with us. But this great administrative team, along with our teachers and many our amazing staff, do great work every day to provide the students of Union County with top quality education. So we thank the Union County Board of Chosen Freeholders for your continued support in all that we do.
All right.
Thank you.
I believe we have a resolution here somewhere. Excuse me. There we go. And Madam Superintendent, that's, and maybe we can move over to the stairs and take a quick photo.
Of course.
And we have another group from Vocational Technical Schools, Future Farmers of America, and their teacher, Ms. Bonnie Baldassar. Would you please come forward with your students? FFA and agricultural education provide a strong foundation for the youth of America for successful careers and a lifetime of choices in global agriculture. And these students, oh, thank you. You brought us gifts as well. And homegrown. Thank you. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you. How are you?
Looks good, that lettuce.
So we also have a resolution for you, and maybe Freeholder Staten would like to say something.
Thank you, Chair. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I'm so honored to have these students with us today, and I thank you for the lovely flowers. Are what is it? Are they flowers or vegetables? Basil. Okay, very good. Yes, I was confused. So, just to let the audience know, the Future Farmers of America, the FAA in agricultural education provides a strong foundation for the youth of America for successful careers and a lifetime of informed choices in global agriculture. It provides a foundation for the future for food, fiber, and natural resource systems. The FFA promotes premier leadership, personal growth, and career success among its members. Agricultural education and the FAA ensures a ready, steady supply of young professionals to meet the growing demands of science, business, technology, and agriculture.
Ms. Baldassar, and maybe the students also would like to speak.
So this is David, and he's going to.
I have the speech. you already know. Okay, so hi, I'm David Tohan. Okay. 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 So, hi, I'm David Tohan, and the Union County FFA chapter reporter, and this is Beatrice Cruz. She's the Union County FFA Sentinel, and our advisor, Ms. Baldassar. So the FFA is for students enrolled in agriculture education, as previously stated, providing a strong foundation for the youth of America and the future of food, fiber, and natural resource systems. FFA promotes premier leadership, personal growth, and career success among its members. Agriculture education and FFA ensure a steady supply of young professionals to meet the growing needs in the science, business, and technology of agriculture. Okay, so a few examples. On February 21st, Beatrice and I participated in NJFFA's Advocacy and Legislative Leadership Day, engaging FFA members with state and industry leaders at the College of New Jersey, which was part of FFA Week. Last June, I had the opportunity to participate in a two-week experience called the Ag Discovery Program through the U.S. Department of Agriculture and NC State University, and our Union County Milk and Quality Products team placed second in the State Career Development event last month. These are just some examples and sampling of what opportunities the FFA provides, and I would like to thank the Freeholder Board for recognizing National FFA Week and FFA's importance in agriculture education for Union County. So, thank you.
So I just wanted to explain what we brought. So through the Union County Kids Dig In grant, which was sponsored by the Freeholders, we now have an aeroponic unit, and currently we're growing Swiss chard, lettuce, and we brought a sampling of lettuce in progress, and you can see how long the roots go in the aeroponic. And then we also do hydroponic lettuce, so here is a sampling of that. And these are Swiss chard plants that continue to grow as we cut the outside leaves off. And part of the grant has a process where we donate 30% of the product. So we've been harvesting and donating. and also the kids get to sample it. So, thank you.
Thank you very much. You know, FFA, it's very much a hands-on program, and clearly you are doing great work. So thanks to all of you, and we have a resolution for you, and we can take a picture.
Very nice.
Business. Now, me and Rebecca.
Thank you. Nice job.
Good work, good work. All right.
All right.
And our next presentation, and thanks once again to all of the BOTEC students and faculty and parents and administrators. You're all doing wonderful work, and we're very, very proud of all of you. Now, our next presentation is for St. Patrick's Day, and I'm going to ask Freeholder Vice Chair Mirabella and Freeholder Williams to join me on this. Every year, we join with the St. Patrick's Day Committee for the parade in Union, and it's an event that we look forward to every year. Maybe Freeholder Vice Chair Mirabella, you'd like to say a few words about the parade?
It's a great parade in Union, right down Union Center, and thousands and thousands of people come to celebrate that parade and honor our Grand Marshal, Sister Persley, so we'll hear from her in a couple of minutes. But it's a great event, and I hope everybody will come out that day. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you. And so now, let's call in the Parade Committee. So, always a pleasure. Oops, sorry. and especially, we have Sister Percy Lee here, who is the principal of Union Catholic High School. Not only a well-respected member of the community, but someone who has raised so many young people and taught them the important values of being good citizens and part of the community, as well as all of the academic subjects. And
I'll just say another couple words about you. Well, you have, Sister Persily has been a catalyst for every major advance that the school has made in the past 38 years. Her, yes, congratulations. Her progressive initiatives have positioned Union Catholic as one of the premier Catholic high schools in the country. So thank you so much, Sister Persily. And we'll be very happy to follow you as you lead the parade as Grand Marshal. Jessica Ann Cunningham is the 2019 General Chairwoman. Jessica was born in Elizabeth with roots that are traced back to Northern Ireland. She attended grammar school in Roselle and graduated from Abraham Clark High School. She earned a Bachelor of Science degree in Hotel and Restaurant Management from Fairleigh Dickinson University and has worked in the hotel business for 11 years before becoming a teacher. So thank you to you, Jessica. And Curry Rickey, welcome, our 2019 adjutant for the St. Patrick's Day Parade. Curry has marched in the very first Union County St. Patrick's Day Parade in 1997 and joined the parade committee in 2005. She served in many capacities, but as recording secretary, vice chairperson, and 2012 parade adjutant, as well as the 2016 general chairwoman. So thank you and congratulations to you. And before we make the presentations, let me give the mic to Sister Persily in case you'd like to make some comments.
Well, as Grand Marshal, I'm thrilled for this recognition. It is an honor, and it means a great deal to me. And the other thing I would like to say at this time is that the support of the Freeholders for the parade, an event of Union County, is awesome. And I want to thank you as Grand Marshal representing the members of the committee itself in expressing thank you to you. And the last thing I'd like to say is I'm committed to, I'm a resident of Union County, and I'm committed to unity. And this event brings us all together, and it doesn't get better than that. Thank you very much.
So our parade is on March 16th. It's on Saturday. We start at 1 p.m. with some grandstand festivities that start at 12 noon, right in the center of Union. Our Freeholders always come out in March. But we would love, it's a family-friendly day, and it's meant for people to come out in the community of all different ethnicities and all different people to come together and just celebrate our heritage and our county and be together. So please come out and join us again on March 16th in the center of Union.
Sure.
I would love to introduce the rest of the committee that's here. So actually, Sister Persily Lee has a tremendous following. So Union Catholic is just a great presence, not only on the parade committee, but also a great presence in our community here in Union County. And so she has hundreds of people that are going to follow her on the parade route, and I can't wait for it. So she brought a few of her aides here today. So we have Betsy and Dave Thornton. We have Dr. Jim Regan, who's the assistant principal at Union Catholic. He's our chief of staff. We're told he's going to keep Sister in line, just in case. And then we have Tony Brennan, who was our 2015 general chair. So thank you.
Thank you very much. And we have some resolutions for you. So, Sister Percy Lee and Jessica Ann. And Curry, and if we could go over there, is that where you'd like us to take a picture? Or you want us to be here? All right, okay.
Yeah. Angel Ostrata there, man. You got me up.
Oh, yes. Hey. Yes. Sorry that we all bumper some
county manager.
I'm good right now, Freeholder.
Come on. Really? I'm out of a picture, kind of a picture.
It's your choice. I'm good. Harry should be in there, too.
That's great. Little
Irishman. Wait,
want to
come
here, please?
I can't see you at
all.
We're good. We'll figure it out.
Always looking to
recruit. What's that?
She's always looking to recruit.
I know. I'm good. Probably
lost my mug in there.
Yeah. Quit it. One, two.
So it's a school night, and we understand that the students have to leave. We will approve communications at next week's regular meeting. Prior to calling upon the various directors to present their resolutions to the board, I'd like to ask County Manager Ed Oatman to make a few remarks regarding his 2019 executive budget. County Manager?
Thank you, Chairman. The county's continuing economic boom, coupled with our sound fiscal management, has produced another strong executive budget that is below cap, maintains the highest bond rating possible, and fully funds Union County's high-quality government services. Our debt level has remained low, far less than the maximum of 2% permitted by the state. We've implemented the following series of fiscal reforms and controls: a hiring freeze for all non-essential positions, in a measure that will save $24.6 million over the next 3 years, we have officially closed the juvenile detention center in Linden. We were once again able to cut costs overall in the corrections department, reducing overtime by $1.3 million. Over the past 3 years, we reduced overtime by a total of $3.1 million and reduced overtime hours by about 56,000. This year's executive budget is $491.6 million. This would increase property taxes by 2% over last year, the lowest in 20 years. On the expenditure side, this year's executive budget continues to cover important services that contribute to Union County's outstanding quality of life. Funding the continuation of the Municipal Infrastructure Grant Program, the Library Grant Program, the Heart Grant Program, and the Union County Means Green Community Gardens Programs. Providing a 2% increase for both Union County College and the Union County Vocational Technical Schools, and funding the construction of turf fields at Ponderosa Park in Scotch Plains, the construction of a new multi-purpose field at Wheeler Park in Linden, and two others at Madison Avenue Park in Rahway. The executive budget also supports the initiatives of Freeholder Chair Betty Jane Kowalski, who announced an emphasis on shared services, as the county will host a shared services summit with its municipal partners, aiming at increasing tax savings and promoting its county partnership with municipalities. In closing, I'd like to thank our Finance Director, B.B. Taylor, and her staff for their work in presenting the budget. We look forward to working with the Freeholder Board, our directors, and county employees throughout the budgetary process. Thank you, Chairman.
Thank you, County Manager. And also some remarks from Vice Chair Mirabella, who is our Chairman of the Fiscal Committee.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Just to follow up on County Manager Obin, we are going to have a series of public hearings on the budget, as we do every year, set in March to review the 2019 executive budget that was presented to the freeholders by the county manager. The first meeting will be March 11th and begins at 5 o'clock at the Galloping Hill Golf Course, 3 Golf Drive in Kenilworth. The second meeting, Tuesday, March 12th, will also be at 5 o'clock here, right here in the Union County Administration Building, 6th floor room, this very room here. The third meeting is Monday, March 18th, begins at 5:30 and will be held in the Westfield Municipal Building, 425 East Broad Street in Westfield. You can go online and see the schedule of departments that will make presentations on those days at ucnj.org. Please note there is no public comment at these meetings. The public is, however, welcome to attend and listen in on the discussion. The Freeholder Board's Fiscal Committee will conduct their review before the Freeholder Board as a whole votes to introduce the budget later this year. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Freeholder Vice Chair. Before we continue with the business, I'd like to acknowledge two public officials who are joining us tonight, Council people from Garwood, Jen Blumenstock and Sean Benoit. Thank you for joining us, in addition to your fellow citizen from Garwood, who's sitting in the row right ahead of you. So now with the business part of the meeting, I will call First Assistant Prosecutor Al Cernadas for the Office of the Union County Prosecutor.
Good evening, Chairwoman, members of the board, and forgive me for my voice because Seton Hall had won last night. The Office of the Prosecutor has three resolutions on for this evening. I can answer any questions if you have any.
Freeholder Estrada.
Thank you very much, Madam Chair. Mr. Cernadas, or Assistant Prosecutor Cernadas, in number two, we are once again approving the updates for the BEAST system, which is what we use to track down evidence in our laboratories. How is that working out? I know that's something that we started a few years back.
The BEAST not only controls everything for our laboratory, it also controls all evidence that moves through our office. So whether it gets, once it comes into possession of a Union County prosecutor's detective, we actually lock it into the BEAST system. The BEAST system is essential to provide the chain of evidence that is needed to prove a case into court. Without that chain of evidence, it would be very difficult to prove our cases in court.
So the BEAST is working very well?
Absolutely. It's essential.
Okay, thank you. BEAST.
Yes, Freeholder Gerritsen.
It's just the timing of it, because the resolution number was back from 2018 that comes into 2019. That's all.
So we've been paying since 2018?
The resolution that was originally done, mm-hmm, was in 2018 that comes into 2019. Okay. That resolution was passed in 2018 for this year. We are amending it to just add this nurse. The sexual assault nurses, they come and they go, and we have to fully staff them. So when people leave, we need to replace them with another sexual assault nurse to make sure that there are people on call in order to respond to a hospital when there is a call out, when there's an allegation of a sexual assault has taken place for an examination.
I still don't clearly understand. Maybe County Manager, you can look into this in the future. We can maybe keep it in the current year, if possible. I mean, I understand the explanation, but if you can just take a look at it, because it just looks little problematic when it's backwards forward. I understand the explanation, but if you can just take a look and let us know. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other questions? Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now I'll call from the Office of the Board of Elections, Administrator Nicole Dorado.
Good evening, Chair, members of the board. before I present my resolution, I just wanted to say that our office will be at the St. Patrick's Day Parade in the legislative office doing demonstrations of our new voting machine. So we'll be there for the duration of the parade. So when you're done walking, please feel free to come by, bring your friends by. I know most of you have already used the machine, but we'll be there also.
Why don't you just participate in the parade, you know, show people on the parade route while you're
That's
marching.
An awesome. We could push it right up.
It's a good idea, right?
That's an awesome idea.
All right, just something to think about.
Love it.
Long extension cord.
Long extension cord. Well, it has an 8-hour backup battery, so we're good. but I do have one resolution on for your consideration this evening. I'd be very happy to answer any questions.
Fielder Hudak?
I have to ask, so $100,000 in bags?
We have to purchase bags to carry the ballot cartridge bins mm-hmm. back on election night because they contain the votes, the right. voter verified paper audit trail. Those have to come back on election night. They are sealable, they're trackable.
The bags themselves are?
They will be sealed.
Okay.
Yep. And so we'll know.
How are they trackable?
Is there barcode? By the seal. Oh, by the seal. It. We'll know, you know, which.
Whether someone tampered with the, what is it?
Yes, all of the bins are sealed and we catalog those numbers and then the seals assigned to the bags are also cataloged. So we'll know after the fact, you know,
and this is, if there are any issues. And this is specifically because of the new machines?
Specifically because of the new machine.
So we have, because I don't recall seeing an order for bags.
We ordered bags in the general election. It was under the threshold because we only ordered 30. Oh. So now we're looking. We had to redesign that bag. They are a little bit heavy once the cards get in there. And our poll workers, we had a post-election meeting with our Westfield poll workers, and one of their concerns was how heavy the bag is, and it didn't have wheels. So they asked for wheels on the bag. So we worked with Rifkin Company, who was awesome. They, everything we asked for, they made happen for these bags. And the polling supply bags, because we had to put in extra provisional ballots to account for the vote by mail issue, where everybody who's requested one since 2016 now receives a vote by mail, we put extra provisional ballots in the bags, made the bags very heavy. So the supply bag can now nest on the ballot bin bag. So it was.
And this is going to be, this is an item that we're going to be able to recycle for
years. Oh, this
going
is a
forward.
One, yes. Yeah, and this is not going to be an annual purchase.
And that's actually what I was alluding to.
Yes,
with
I'm
this
sorry.
This is not something that we, no, you're fine. That was something that we have not, I've not seen regularly purchased. So I imagine we've had these other bags and servers
forever.
Forever. Yeah. It's time.
It's
time. Time to bite the bullet.
They have holes in them. It's time. Yes.
Oh, well,
but
I can appreciate now understanding they have wheels. That makes more sense.
And the poll workers will be very happy to see that they have wheels because they're aging. You know, they're older. And
it's a very long day.
It's heavy. Yeah. They are heavy once you put the cards in there.
Well, I also want to say that I did have an opportunity as well to demo the new machine, and I think it's going to be a great choice. It was a great choice, and I think it's going to be a great inclusion to Election Day. For what it's worth, my kids love playing with it. So, it really is a great machine, and I know it's going to be a challenging election cycle or two to get people used to the new system. But I think it's going to be well worth the expense. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you.
Fielder Canados, did you want to ask
Thank
something?
Thank you, Chair. Yes. Just how many bags is it? Are you guys going to purchase?
We are purchasing 485 supply bags and 440 of the rolling bin bags.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you. And yes, Fielder State.
Hi, Nicole.
Hello.
Quick question. The office hours for to test the voting machines during the parade will be what time?
We're going to be there noon when the activities start, once okay. the bandstand starts, and then we'll be there for the duration of the parade, so probably 2 or 3.
Okay, great. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Just a quick one. Does the machine presently come with a bag?
I'm sorry, with?
The machine themselves, when we purchase them, do they come with a bag already?
They do not come with a bag.
So the bag has been always our responsibility since day one?
Yes. That's one of the ancillary
I rest my case.
Purchases.
Thank you.
That you find out after the fact. Yeah.
And you also have been demonstrating the machine at your offices.
Yes, we are every Saturday. We're at the Fraser Building from 9 to 1. We started that in January and we'll be there through the general election. We also started in January. We're at the Union County Courthouse on Tuesdays, 11 to 3. So we're trying to get that out. We are working with the municipal clerks in the 9 municipalities that we're going to be in the primary to set demonstration hours. We just set Garwood. We'll be in Garwood April 13th and May 4th, 9 to 1. We're going to be at Trailside for Earth Day for all the festivities at Trailside and the Loop on April 28th. We are going to be visible. We're scheduling night hours and Saturday hours where we can in each of those municipalities. So, okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank
Administrator
you.
Dorado.
Thank you.
Madam Chair, not for Nicole, but for just our purposes. Can we just get an updated, like a one pager on the 9? A note was provided, it might be just a copy, but just to update how many we have so far and to the point of any additional things that we might need to consider. Just like a little quick one pager so that we all are briefed of where we are, where's the status today? On the machines.
On machines.
Yes.
Or is that county manager?
Sure.
I was saying that given some of the information you just shared, you mentioned 9 municipalities that it's going into. You mentioned we obviously have purchased some of these. There might be other items. Can we just get a quick one pager at some point? Just what's the status, where we are? It might already be created.
Nicole has a one pager about what towns are going to be in the primary, what's going to be in general.
Yes.
Just to recirculate
out a press
it.
Release.
It might be there. I just refresh my memory.
No problem.
Thank you.
No problem.
All righty.
No
thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sorry about that.
Thank you.
That was his fault.
That was your fault.
And before I call up Director Taylor for the Department of Finance, I just want to note that our Director of Engineering and Public Works, Joe Graziano, is here. Celebrating his 29th birthday, we're very pleased to
happy birthday. I love birthdays. Happy birthday.
So, thank you, Director Graziano. And now Director Taylor.
Good evening, Chairman and members of the board. The Department of Finance has one resolution for your consideration this evening, and I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Seeing no questions, thank you, Director Taylor. So, if any freeholders have additional resolutions to add to the regular meeting agenda and or any friendly amendments, would you please mention them now? Freeholder Garrettson?
Yes, I'd like to do several friendly amendments. Actually, if you can go to Freeholder Estrada and I'll have them numbered. Sorry, I looked at them, but I'll...
Oh, okay. Freeholder Estrada?
Surely. I'd like to add myself to number 2, 3, 6, 7. And I have made a recommendation to Mr. Pelletieri about when they have, in some cases, they have had names of the individuals and then by the whole board, just to include the chairperson and from the whole board rather than otherwise, if, you know, it is already spoken. I mean, we said that's pretty clear then.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
Rebecca, you want me to explain that again? No? You got it?
I would like... All right. If I may, I'd like to add, be added to number 6, numbers 8, number 9. I think number 9 should possibly be from the entire board, if possible.
Yes, I agree. Entire okay. board for 9.
The number 11, please. And that concludes my request.
Okay, thank you. Any other freeholders? Oh, Freeholder State?
Yes. Yes, I'd like to be added to number 5, 6, and 9.
And I will have a few laudatory resolutions and possibly some advisory board resolutions to add to the regular meeting next week.
Madam Chair?
Oh, yes.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I will have a number of sponsorship resolutions as a result of the fiscal meeting this evening. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you. So tonight, we do have a need to go into executive session. County Council, would you please make your statement relative to tonight's session?
Thank you, Madam Chair. Pursuant to the provisions of the Open Public Meetings Act, the public body may enter into executive session for the purpose of discussing certain enumerated subjects. This board now wishes to enter into executive session for the purpose of discussing attorney-client privilege communication, possible settlement, and discussion of possible settlement in the matter of Valerie Fishback versus Union County et al. The minutes of the executive session shall be separated from the minutes of the open public session. The minutes of the executive session, redacted as appropriate and necessary, shall be available in approximately 30 days. Clerk to the board shall retain the minutes until such time as the confidential limitations have been removed, at which time they shall be made available. Upon affirmative vote of a majority of the members present, the board may retire to executive session. Upon their return, it will not be taking any formal action on the matter this evening.
Thank you, County Council. May I have a motion to enter into executive?
So moved, Madam Chair.
Chair, before we make that motion, I think had a couple of amendments for
oh,
the
oh, I'm sorry. I didn't notice you.
Well. I thought you did. Oh. Never mind.
But I appreciate for the hudak I do.
Never mind. I thought, I thought I was standing up for the right side of the dais.
Okay. We're okay. And so that was made by you, Freeholder Hudak, and was seconded by?
I moved
by
it.
You moved it.
I
okay.
For that
Vice
chair.
Chair. Thank you. Seconded. Okay. You've got that, Mr. Clerk?
I got moved by Vice Chairman Mirabella
and seconded by
Hudak. Freeholder Hudak.
Yes.
With that, Freeholder?
Could you please call the roll?
Freeholder Estrada?
Yes.
Freeholder Garrettson?
Yes.
Freeholder Granados?
Aye.
Freeholder Hudak?
Aye.
Freeholder Palmieri Mudet?
Yes.
Freeholder Staten?
Yes.
Freeholder Williams?
Aye.
Freeholder Vice Chairman Mirabella?
Aye. Thank you, Freeholder.
Chair Kowalski?
Yes.
Chair, you have 9 votes in the affirmative.
Thank you. We now will go into executive session.
Oh, God. Did you guys find one of those
things? Just dick.
So moved, Madam Chair.
Thank you. Second?
You're welcome. Second.
Clerk of the board, please call the roll.
None of that. That's
Chair, this is to return from exec. Freeholder Estrada?
Yes, to return.
Second.
No. Freeholder Garrettson? That's good.
Yes.
Freeholder Granados?
Aye.
Freeholder Hudak?
Aye.
Freeholder Palmieri Mudet?
Yes.
We have Freeholder Staten?
Yes.
Freeholder Williams?
Aye.
Vice Chair Mirabella?
I return.
And Chair Kowalski?
Yes.
Chair, you have 9 freeholders voting in the affirmative to return to our meeting.
Thank you. County Council Barry, do you have anything to announce as a result of executive?
No announcements. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Okay. And I believe Freeholder Granados has something from the Open Space Trust Fund?
Thank you, Chair. Based off tonight's Trust Fund meeting, we'll have 2 resolutions for next week's meeting.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chair.
May I have a motion to adjourn?
So moved, Madam Chair.
Second.
Whoa.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Yes.
Y'all baby. Oop, there it is.
$7 right now. I just leave the moment.